Abo abebaka kubanga mukama wafe yenyini alika okuva mu ggulu n'okwogerera waggulu n'eddoboozi lya malayika omukulu n'ekkondeere lya Katonda n'abo abafiira mu Kristo.
That if you are neutral in a situation of injustice, then you have chosen the side of the oppressor. The church leaders have largely been either silent or outrightly on the side of oppression when people are oppressed. For us as a generation, it speaks volumes about church. We remember that we are living in a generation where young people, young men and women, are constantly being driven away from the church or from religion. Why? Because those that we believe are supposed to say the truth, to speak truth to power, have either been threatened or compromised. Let this be a reminder, ladies and gentlemen. Let the world not constantly mourn the loss of the Archbishop Jonah Lwanga, as a loss of truth, as a loss of a voice. Because he taught us, he was a religious teacher. He taught us, it is our time to show that we learned. And to our leaders and the rulers, it is important, very important, that we are reminded, especially in death, that all of us are but just mortal. We are the same. At least let's remember that when we are being laid to rest. It's supposed to remind us, ladies and gentlemen, that in this time that we live, when the common people are no longer free to speak the truth, to defend their rights, it is only the religious leaders that we were relying on to defend our rights. I will not repeat the many words that the man lying before us spoke to the nation against injustice, against clinging to power, against oppression, and now we are laying him to rest. All of us are present. The world is watching. Now that he has, by the grace of God, lived his life to fulfillment, it is upon us to carry on the legacy. While we lay him to rest, it is our time to stand up and work. Work with our mouths, work with our bodies, but stand for what is right. Stand for what is right. Let us be reminded to stand for what is right. At least let's take it from the house of God today.
What? I want to thank the Honorable Chagulanyi for his kind remarks about the late Archbishop. As a mother, I would like also to implore you that in our culture here in Buganda, we should share our things internally as a family. For instance, there are some few things which we need to refer to our table, like the iPod, so that when the guests come, they see us as brothers and sisters, not just. So I'm just saying this to you as my, as your mom, I'm your mother, you are my son.